Hi, my name is Jane Pirani. I'm the Artistic Director and co-owner of the Anne Roberts School of Dancing and also the Director of Ulysses. Ulysses has now been going for 15 years and this is our first season that we will ever be doing online, and who knows, it might happen in the future. It would be wonderful. Originally, the theme of Gasp was about a response to what's happening in the world, bushfires, global warming, a lack of air, a lack of governments taking strong stands on things, and basically my response to this through the arts. The entire season is now dedicated to that, which of course is also now looking at coronavirus, the confinement that that has put upon people, the loneliness that that has brought to us, the lack of community cohesion, all of those things we're trying to just, our response to it. There's no answer, but it is our response to it, and it is also to keep young people working, creating, playing, and giving a voice to the arts. I'm encouraging younger choreographers to have a voice, to learn, to develop, because that's the only way to create, to develop the craft. Gasping for air, gasping, you know, to find the economy again in our country and the whole world, and actually just trying to keep the practice going. We've been on pause for a while, and you know, I just want to get us going again. And while we can here in the regions, which is fantastic, we have to take this opportunity to do it. Welcome everybody to Ulysses' show of Gasp. This is our inaugural season of an online worldwide season, and we welcome you to it.
Hi, my name is Cassie. I have been with Ulysses for a long while now, under the beautiful Dane Reid.
When COVID hit, my focus changed a little bit. I tried to bring that into my piece and started exploring how our responses to COVID and global warming might be linked. I mean, both of them are global crises that require a local to, sorry, global to local response. Both are issues which are affecting our health, and both are things that need to be guided by science.
I don't really have a plan when I come into choreograph. I try and keep it very organic. I have some ideas when I come in, and then I try and let go of them so that it's all very natural and just let it evolve. I guess, you know, climate change affects how we relate to other species on the planet. That's just COVID, and even possibly at the end of this, how we might all experience a regained sense of community at the end of it. So it's just the first time I've used such a small amount of people as well as just females. I thought it would be easier using a smaller group, but it's actually been a bit harder, but I'm really happy with experience, and I've learned a lot, and hopefully everyone enjoys what I've created.
Thank you. Hi, my name's Dane. I've been dancing for about 15 years now. I'm 19 this year, and I've been choreographing for the Ulysses Dance Company for 2 years now. This year we're doing Gasp, and my take on that is a bit of try to take in the present day, you know, with COVID, trying to incorporate all the changing behaviours in social interactions and lack of. I've tried to split my piece into three parts, and I start with sort of a pre-COVID, and then isolation, and then post-COVID. Lacking that creative outlet was a really tough thing, especially as a choreographer. All you want to do is just make work and that sort of stuff, be creative, but when you're at home in your lounge room, there's not really much you can do, so it was a bit of a tough scene, I guess, during the whole isolation. I'm exploring this Portuguese expression. It's called saudade, and it's basically longing for something that's probably never going to come back, and my take on that is social interaction. So really taking advantage of all those moments that we get with people and really not getting those anymore the way we used to.
But will you? My name is Suzie Searight and I've been choreographing with Ulysses for 2 years now. This year I've been inspired by human interaction and tactile touch pre and post COVID and how we've seen that shift in our society. So playing with the ideas of isolation, elbow bumping, social distancing, but also with the extreme opposite of touching that we took for granted before the pandemic. The most beautiful thing as working as a choreographer is working with the different dancers and how each body moves differently in space with one another. The different shapes and colours you might see with a big group of people, so how that might shift between solos and duos and groups. And yeah, it's just really beautiful seeing how that interacts in the space.
So come back to the circle.
Through technology, I think will be really interesting to see how dance can be captured, and I think it's a really nice opportunity to use that and test us as choreographers to work with what choreography works best for screen and kind of develop it in a new way rather than just relying on live audiences.
Thank you. Thank you.
Originally, the theme of Gasp was about a response to what's happening in the world, the bushfires, global warming, a lack of air, a lack of governments taking strong stands on things, and basically my response to this through the arts. The entire season is now dedicated to that, which of course is also now looking at coronavirus, the confinement that that has put upon people, the loneliness that that has brought to us, the lack of community cohesion, all of those things we're trying to just, our response to it. There's no answer, but it is our response to it, and it is also to keep young people working, creating, playing, and giving a voice to the arts. I'm encouraging younger choreographers to have a voice, to learn, to develop, because it's the only way to create, to develop the craft. Gasping for air, gasping, you know, to find the economy again in our country and the whole world, and actually just trying to keep the practice going. We've been on pause for a while, and you know, I just want to get us going again. And while we can here in the regions, which is fantastic, we have to take this opportunity to do it. Thank you.